I haven't been feeling myself lately. I've been feeling so down, not eating healthy, not exercising. It's really caught up with me. It's at a point now where I'm just like, I want to change something. Yeah, it's gonna be a long process, but I'm just ready to change.
I don't like exercising, I don't like working out, I don't like running. Any physical activity, sign me out.
Before I had started my weight loss journey, there were so many unhealthy habits that I didn't realize I had, whether it was not loving my body enough, not appreciating myself enough, overeating and compensating for when I felt stressed. I really wanted to make a change to become the healthiest version of myself, a version of myself that I could love. This transformation started with a commitment, with a plan that I'd written down over and over again because I wanted to get this right. I'd struggled to lose weight for over 3 years, and this time was going to be the time that I proved myself right. And I proved to myself how strong I was. I used to think strength was being able to post a glorious Instagram picture every day effortlessly, but I actually realized on this journey that real strength is determination, the motivation, the willpower that you have inside you. When you unleash that, you are unstoppable. When you unleash that, you become the healthiest and the best version of yourself. And when I started this journey, that journey was only just about to begin. I realized I wanted to lose weight as it started one evening when I was sorting out my wardrobe, trying on which clothes I wanted to take to charity and which clothes I wanted to keep. It was to my realization that no clothes fit anymore. Nothing was fitting me and I wasn't able to fit into anything. This burned my desire. That evening, I cried. I looked in the mirror and I looked away again because I didn't want to be in this position. I hadn't realized how unhealthy I'd got. I just wanted to be the healthiest version of me. And for the first time in my life, I was determined. I was ready. I was going to get there. Sometimes we'll have a week long of rest days, 3 days of cheat days, but the key is to never give up. And this time I was ready to give it my everything. I used to track my transformation every single day, and it would affect my mood so much if nothing shifted or nothing had changed. Now I use other methods because an inch down on the waist might not show up on the scales, but it's important to know that your process is still happening. I learned to start celebrating my wins. Initially, I said I didn't like running. I didn't want to do it. I didn't like the feeling of getting hot and sweaty or having to be out of breath, but I challenged myself. And the main thing I take away from this journey is pushing yourself outside your comfort zone. Growth happens where we feel the most uncomfortable. In order to get somewhere new, we have to make changes, and I pushed myself. I started to enjoy it. I trained myself to enjoy it. I started to track my steps and turn this into a fun incentive. Having failed so many times, I didn't want to go to the gym again. I didn't want to have another failed attempt where I just gave up. I'm someone who struggled so much with wanting to snack all the time, lack of motivation, lack of wanting to get up. The thought of sweating would annoy me so much, and I just did not want to exercise. But I committed, and as you know, it started off with one Chloe Ting routine that was going to be the change that changed everything. It was when I was doing these Chloe Ting routines every single day for 6 days a week for 10 to 20 minutes a day is that I started to see these changes. These changes didn't just come about because it was an effective workout, but also because for the first time I was eating the right foods. I used to always get my food and nutrition misconstrued because so many advice tells us you should eat this, you should eat that. Don't get me wrong, knowing where to start with your nutrition is so important, but it was when I started to make my nutrition so tailored to me, knowing what worked with me. Every 7 days, if I hadn't lost weight or if I didn't feel a shift, I'd change it. I'd change it and not be obsessed with my calories. I stopped counting my calories after the first month. And I focused on when I was hungry, when I wasn't, portion sizing, all the things that really matter to allow your mind to not feel restricted, to allow yourself to feel free. Immerse yourself in the process. And this means doing whatever works for you best. Of course, a deficit is a deficit, and you will get there no matter what. What to do was to keep on going.
Hey guys, so welcome back, and I really wanted to do this video for you guys because so many of you guys came into my journey when I first showed you back this time last year when it all really sort of began, and it was very slow and steady in the beginning. I just wanted to use this video to reflect on it with you guys. I'm going to use this time to tell you a bit about my journey, tell you a bit about the tips and, you know, motivation, finding the right nutrition. So many people comment on my videos or in DMs saying, okay, how do I find the right nutrition? How do I know if I'm eating too much or too little? All these other things. And I really want to use this video as an opportunity to discuss with you guys, because if you know that I struggled to lose weight for, you know, ages and ages, years upon years, when I was trying different things, so many little things that go together really, really make the biggest difference. And if you're wanting to go on this journey, you want to do it, think about December. I showed you guys a snippet of my journey so far and how it's been, all the ups and downs, the struggles, the things that I thought were weight loss myths that I was always doing, you know, the counting calories so heavily all the time, or the different workouts that I thought were the right ones because of what everyone else tells you. And how when I changed that, that is when I finally started to see differences. Now, one of the main things that you guys always want me to touch on is nutrition. Are you eating too much? Are you eating too little? When do you know if you're eating the right thing? A lot of experts will tell you that 80% of your nutrition will help your weight loss or aid your weight loss, and that you're working out, it's only a fraction. Rather than going to the gym and trying to burn 1,000 calories, you can actually create those deficits by sitting at home and just picking the right foods for the day. So you're really, really utilizing your time without having to go in hours of gym work, hours of strenuous work, when you think about busy schedules and all these other things. How do you find out you're eating the right nutrition? Because this is something that I struggled with for so long. And as I say, that's based on the so many myths that we get taught about nutrition and all these healthy diets and fad diets and get fit quick diets. And how you calculate your nutrition. My biggest advice for everyone is starting off with an online calorie calculator. I had the really good benefit of having a nutritionist, a dietitian, was able to calculate it for me. But ideally, your online calculator is going to give you around the same results with a same ballpoint marker anyway. What you do with your online calorie calculator is it's going to calculate your current weight, your goal weight, your height, and your age and your gender. And it's going to work out how many calories you need a day to get to your goal weight based off what you currently weigh. And this is why when people ask me how many calories do I eat, I always say it's so important to first of all realize that yours is going to be so different to the next person, because not only is this going to be based off of BMI and metabolic rate, but what I eat might make you gain weight. And if your goal is to lose weight, you don't want to be eating what I eat. So always really allow yourself to understand how important it is to be getting the right nutrition for you, no matter what anyone else eats, the right nutrition for you. Now, once you've gone on your online calorie calculator and it gives you that ballpoint marker, it doesn't stop there. After this, what you really want to do is use the 7-day rule. Now, I made myself a 7-day rule. I made it up as a little incentive to help me know that I'm on the right track. What the 7-day rule is, every 7 days, you're going to eat certain types of food within your calorie intake to see if it aids you in your weight loss. After this, don't count calories heavily. I always say you can relax after this, but when you really, really want to test out know if you're eating the right foods, use the 7-day rule. And if it doesn't work, if it is working, change up. If it is working, keep it the same and continue doing that until, you know, you reach a point where your weight loss has stopped or anything like that. And I always say use every 7 days to test out if your food routine is working for you. That's the best test to do. And by using, you know, your range of whether it's 1,200 to 1,800 calories for weight loss, you're always going to be able to play around with different types of food in that area of intake. That's what really, really helped me, because no way to know the perfect type of foods until you use every 7 days to test out a certain combination and changing it up a little bit until it really, really works for you. I really wanted to move into nutrition and learn about nutrition because I was a massive snacker. I was someone who, I would say, I didn't really have much self-control with my foods. I'd be all right all day and it would always get to about evening time where I just want to eat everything and anything. And I think what really, really helped me tackling my heavy snacking or my love for snacks and wanting to always break my healthy eating day in the evenings is that I managed to find food combinations earlier in the day that would help me maintain my fullness. And what you need to do is try and find foods that help you maintain your fullness. On a whole, usually carbohydrates allow you to maintain your fullness a lot better. So if you're someone who ends up snacking a lot, find out what time of day it is. After which, you want to really try and, you know, add your carbohydrates earlier on so that by the time it comes to that snacking point of the day, you're like, I'm feeling full, I'm feeling satisfied, I don't need any more snacks. And it takes practice. It's going to take practicing and resilience and pushing through. But carbohydrates tend to be those foods that help you keep a little bit more full. I always say to people, there are different types of foods that are going to help you better along your weight loss journey, and carbohydrates end up being one of those. If someone wants a snack, they're craving, you know, something in the evening, I would always tell them you're better off eating carbohydrates such as banana or pasta to help you feel a little bit more full, because those are slow releases in the body. By someone having chocolate bar instead every single time they want a snack, now and again is okay, but every single time they want a snack, what you're doing is you're keeping your cravings active. You want to reverse all these cravings that we've had in our bodies forever and ever and ever by training ourselves to want different things when we're hungry, or to want different levels of food when we're hungry, to different types of food when we're hungry. That's really going to help us train into this new body, this new routine that we really, really want to achieve. The other thing that I absolutely loved about taking you guys on this journey so far already is that I remember I made a video on the day that I really wanted everything to change. This is the day that I was like, right, I want to put everything into gear. One of the main things about that is that I always usually struggled with motivation. And I remember when I was crying at this time that I was like, I struggle with motivation so much. That's one of the things that lets me down. So people ask me continuously, how do you find your motivation? I'm going to give you some of the best tips that I can find for motivation, because that's only going to be one of your biggest hindrances from getting over here. And you're here. Motivation is the part in between that pushes you close to your goal, whether that's through, you know, times when you're not losing weight, times when maybe your workouts don't feel effective, times when motivation is that thing that keeps you going to try something new, that keeps you going to want to push to find something better, want to push to find something newer. With my motivation, I have some key things, which is listen to a podcast while you're doing a workout, get a treadmill that's really, really affordable, and work out in front of the TV. If you can't, because I didn't do this for a lot of the time, so I wanted to do things that were inexpensive, affordable, that I could really, really do. Get a support system who are also on the same journey, who can help you, motivate you to work out. Write down your goal every single day, and I really want you to repeat this to yourself and tell yourself how much you want it. I remember there were so many times that I wanted to give up, but it's important to know that you can have cheat days. You can have 2 cheat days in a row if you really want to and still get to your goal. There are 365 days in a year. You have 2 cheat days this week. You've still got the rest of the entire year to continue and to keep on going. And that's what really solidifies someone who's motivated and who isn't. If you're driven enough to understand that you can have your cheat days and you keep going, you have to keep pushing through. Going on this journey to love my body again, love the process again, love being healthy again. You've got to want healthiness for yourself. And that's the main goal for this, not the number on the scales, to just want healthiness for yourself. And by healthiness is giving yourself that lenience and realization that you don't need to be so fixated and strict every single time. It's about balance and still living your life. I can happily say this transformative journey changed my life, and I'm sure it's going to change so many of your lives as well. When you get there, get on board, set yourself a goal and push yourself to get to where exactly where you want to be. Now, I love you guys so much. Don't forget to come over and follow my Inspirational Fitness page on Instagram, as well as my fitness podcast page as well. Give this video a massive thumbs up, turn your bell notifications on so you get notified every single time that I upload, and subscribe. I love you guys so much. I'll see you guys very, very soon. Bye guys.